Yes, good evening, students. So we'll wait for a few minutes for everyone to join and then we'll start the class. Okay. So we'll continue with the same topic now. Okay, we are waiting till 6:05 and then we'll start. Okay. So I think, student, am I audible clearly? Asha, Raksha, Didya, and Ayushi, kindly confirm, I think.
Yes, sir, you're audible.
Yes, sir, thank you so much. So we are waiting, I think, for 2 more minutes and then we'll start. Okay, it's already 6 o'clock right now. So, any query to anyone from the last session, please? Regarding, I think, what we have discussed, we have covered up this introduction part of consumer behavior. Then we have covered up impulsive buying, factor influencing consumer behavior and its process. Factor influencing behavior, I think, personal, social, and cultural factor we have discussed. Subculture, I think, we have also covered up. Social factors. Reference group, I think we are not done or we are done. Please kindly confirm, students.
No, sir, reference group we haven't covered.
Okay, I think this was the last slide, I think, what I remember. Social factors, family, reference groups, and so role and status.
No, sir, we discussed in social class. After joint decision making process.
Okay. After decision making process, this is we are done or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Cultural, we are done.
Yes, sir.
Subculture, we
social
are.
Social also.
Social also.
Then after joint decision making process also completed.
Okay. Yes. I remember. Yes. Social class.
But till this. After that, we discussed case study.
Okay, from personal factor, I think we have to start then.
Yes, sir.
Okay, wait. Fine. let's start, I think, now. So the next factor which will affect the consumer behavior, which is about your personal factors. Okay. Now, personal factor is basically a factor which is unique to each and every individual, because each and every person having their own demand, having their own lifestyle, having their, you could say, own way of living. An age group as well, again, one of the most important factor about the age group as well. Okay, so in this case, the important category is about personal factors. Personal factors related to purchasing any product or services varies from person to person, depends on their demographic analysis. Okay, this demographic analysis, the major factor we are covering right now, that includes your age, life cycle, personality, occupation, economic situation, values and lifestyle. Okay, so there's a major, you could say, factor which come under personal factors. Okay, we'll discuss all this one by one. Now, as we discuss about the first part, about the age. Okay, so as we know that we have different age group, and according to the age group, the purchasing habits may also change. Okay, for example, when we discuss about the you could say teenagers, the how the lifestyle is they maintain, it's very different. The eating habits are very different. When we discuss about, you could say, the age after 40, 50 plus, the age group having different lifestyle, okay, different way of living their life, different way of their eating habits. Okay, recreational activities are also different. Their social groups are very different. Okay, the way they are actually going for their luxury as well, it's very different. So when we discuss about the age, it's all about the personal factors of an individual. Okay, that is about age. Second is about your life cycle stage. Life cycle stages, that is, if you are an infant, if you are a kid, if you are an adult, if you are an elder, definitely according to the age, according to the age group, if we talk about a life cycle, we talk about, okay, starting from infant till the old age. Okay, you have different purchasing power, purchasing behavior. Any example, I think, please, from your side now, about life cycle stages. Because the needs and wants also changes as per the life cycle. Haji. Everyone, please. Any example from life cycle stages, please? Students, an example about life cycle stages, like we talk about infants. Okay, infants are the early age of an individual up to 10 years. The habits, like when then they prefer, actually usually about the baby products. Their brand preference also very different. They go for First Cry, they go for, you could say, mamas.com. There are so many examples which we can quote over here. Okay. Once the people actually get their early age, definitely their requirements are different when it's come to their lifestyle, when it comes to their clothing, when it's come to their preferences, like they start going schools, they understand the things, their gadget requirements are different. Once they cross the age of 18, that adult age, basically when it comes, it's about the different requirement the individual do have, depend upon their occupation, depends upon their life journey as well. Okay, so they have a priorities as well regarding their jobs, regarding their businesses, regarding their family. They might get married soon. And once they get married, they have a different requirements. Okay, so as you can understand, the life cycle stages depends upon the purchasing behavior of an individual. Like, for example, a person who is only single, he is not married. Definitely the life cycle stage and the requirements would be very different. A person who is married, living in a joint family, okay, having very different requirements. Okay, so that is about the life cycle stage we are talking right now. Okay. Now, the next part is personality. Now, depends on the personality type, definitely a person's lifestyle may also differ. Okay, can anyone give an example about personality type first of all? हाँ जी स्टूडेंट्स, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल कैन एनीवन टेल मी व्हाट आर द पर्सनालिटी टाइप्स? What is personality? First of all, I think we have discovered discussed already in the previous classes. Student, I think if you'll speak up, that would be far better for me to actually discuss these points. Personality. What is personality? First of all. In a simple language, if we will actually go for that, is about the perceived behavior or how a particular person perceive about any situation. Okay, that will come under personality. Now, first of all, tell me types of personality. I think we discussed already in the classes in the OB. Yes and yes or no, please. Kindly confirm so that I can start something on that. Okay. Student, please kindly yes or no at least. Okay.
No, sir.
Okay. So when we discuss about the first of all personality, as we are talking right now, the personality, as in a simple language, we can understand. Now, there are basically four types of personality. The one is called assertive. Yeah, I think I have already discussed with you when we were talking about the OB. Third personality type is expressive. I'm discussing only major part, okay? Not all personality types, because there are total 20 to 30 personality types. Yeah, but as per the marketing, we are discussing only then analytic. Okay. Now, what is the meaning of assertive, students? Assertive personality.
Positive.
Okay. So what about the various traits of assertive personality? Can anyone tell about, like, someone discuss about positive approach? Okay, very good. They are actually more louder. They are more actually, we talk about confident when we talk about whenever they are going to purchase any product or any services. Okay. So apart from positive, that is about the animated. Confident. Take a very simple example. If I have to purchase one, you could say one car for my family, from utility vehicle. Okay. So rather ask about what utility vehicles they have, it's better that I will ask them about, like, I just want the major, or you could say latest vehicle from your side. Okay. So whenever we are talking about a particular person who is very positive, who is very simplified when it comes to their purchasing habits, who is, you could say, more constructive when it comes to their purchasing habits. So assertive is all about basically the mindset of an individual who is very positive, who just want to purchase certain products based on their behavior. Okay, based on the behavior means based on the positive approach. Okay, that is called the assertive. I hope that's clear. Any example? Any example? Yes, students, any example, please. Assertive behavior. Like, for example, if you want to purchase any laptop or any computer device, you know that there are so many technicality which we have to face whenever we are planning to go for purchasing a computer or laptop. Okay. In these cases, you know already that whenever we are planning to purchase any product, a particular person may have a sufficient knowledge, first of all, and they will ask directly the questions which he is actually expecting. For example, if I have to purchase an HP laptop, I will go for my configurations. And according to my configuration, definitely I'll ask the details from the company or from the representative. That is about the assertive behavior. Any query to anyone, please? Assertive behavior. Any example I'm expecting from you now? Yes, students. Yes, students, please kindly go for it. I think I'm not getting a response today. Mr. Anuj, Nam, Raksha, what happened today? Hanji. An example from your side, I hope so. Yes, students. No? Okay, let's leave it then. I think next part we have amiable personality types. Okay. Now, when we discuss about the amiable personality types, they are, you could say, more enthusiastic. They believe actually in making personal relationship with your business partners, with the companies if we talk about, okay. And they are, you could say, trustworthy and loyal to the particular company and the brands, okay. Usually they take decisions very, very correctly by keeping in consideration about the various factors, okay. So when we discuss about the amiable personality types, enthusiasts, they are focus on more personal relationship. Okay. Then they know about how to create the rapport in the organization. So rapport creation, which is more about, you could say, personal relationship. Okay, an example of this, please. Amiable personality types. Like, for example, if I am actually going for my house security services or any, you could say, services which I required for my house maintenance. Okay, for that purpose, I need to select any security company, those who will take care about my house and the safety of the same. For that purpose, definitely I'll just keep a relationship with the security personnel or with the security team in a way so that they will actually feel more participative. They will feel more, you could say, close to the family, like a family, we can say. So these type of decision making, when we are considering a particular company, a business partner or an organization as our personal, you could say, characteristics. Okay. So that will come under amiable. Okay. Any example, please? Student, I think the class won't be interactive. It is not actually a worthy class in terms of marketing management. Okay. So I will request everyone to speak up. I think that would be far better. Haji. Anyone? Student, I hope so. Am I clearly audible, please? Students, am I audible? I think so.
Yes, you are clearly audible.
Yes, am I audible? That is perfectly fine. Thank you so much. But I need some, you could say, interactive class, I think, on daily basis. It's not like one-way delivery should not be there in marketing, especially. Okay. So I need your contribution, your inputs as well, so that the class would be more interactive. Haji.
Yes, actually, I'm currently traveling, so I'm unable most of the time unable to understand your voice clearly. Also.
Okay, understood.
There is a problem for my side.
No worries, Chandrabhushan. Considered, okay? Haji. Huh. Okay, I think if you are not giving the answers, we will move to the third personality type, which is called expressive. Okay? What is expressive personality type? Now, at least it's very simple. Yes, students. So, I'll just keep
it. Expressive means showing emotions and feelings.
Yes, definitely. If you'll just take a characteristics, is all about in expressive, it is more creative. They are outspoken as well, they're outgoing, or we can say outspoken. Whatever they want, they speak up front. Okay, first of all, they believe in intuition as well. Intuition means what they personally think from inside about whether to go for this product or not. According to their, you could say, might be their intuitions, their beliefs, their values. According to that, they decide upon that whether they have to purchase that product or not. Yes, Raksha, you are correct, actually. Any example? Like sometimes it's happened in our life, like whenever we are in a dilemma, okay. We always, you could say, select any any one product out of the choices. Okay. So in such a cases, we always actually more about expressive. Expressive means we speak up front that what exactly we want. Okay. Like, for example, if I want to purchase a mobile phone, if I have a choices of iPhone 11, iPhone 12, okay, I will actually just think about my expenses. I will think about my future financial obligations. I will think about my needs and wants. And accordingly, I'll just actually express myself and just purchase the product accordingly. Okay, so when we discuss about the expressive, it's all about what exactly you think from inside. You are not at all confused, first of all. You're outspoken about what exactly you want. If you are looking for any discounts, any negotiation, you will speak up front. Okay, so that is about the expressive. An example, please. Haji students, any example? Students, I am expecting one example now, at least from one of the student.
When go for purchasing of iPhone, and then we decide to purchase, and also discuss with the discount what the seller is going to give us. After discussing all the things, we are going to take decision, final decision.
Yes.
On the basis of our financial you can say status and our full requirement.
Yes. Okay, good. Thank you, Chandrabhushan. Okay, let's move to the last, I think, part. Anyone else, I think, wanted to give any inputs? No, I hope so. Okay, fine. Let's move to the last one, and I'm expecting a example from your side. It's very simple. We talk about analytical personality type. Okay, these individuals or these personality type people, they actually take their decision on the basis of data. They take a decision on the basis of figure, numbers, we can say, okay? Facts, if we talk about, okay? So like any decision making you take in a life regarding the data, figure and facts, like for example, if I want to purchase a mutual fund or any equity shares, what exactly I'll do? I'll just go through with the analysis, first of all, what exactly the performance of the company, what dividend and returns the company is providing. According to that, I'll decide upon whether I have to take a decision making or not. One more important thing, which I want to tell you about these four personality types, the time taken to time required to actually take a decision making in the for a particular, you could say, purchasing behavior or purchasing, it's very, very less in terms of assertive, comparatively higher in case of amiable. Expressive also take higher time as compared to amiable. An analytical one always take longest time as compared to above three. Okay, so time consuming is basically increasing from assertive to analytical. Clear, I think. So time consumption increases from 1 to 4 whenever we need to take any decision making. Okay. And the students, is this clear? So I'm expecting now at least some examples from your side. Mr. Poonam, I think what happened today? No reply. Raksha, Anu.
I'm not feeling well, so that's why I'm not.
Poonamji, I'm also not feeling well actually, but still, if you will just concentrate on the studies, the things would be better for you.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, sure. Even I am also in fever today, but still I am taking the classes. You can understand from my voice as well, actually.
Yes, sir. Your voice is not like sounds that you are having some problem.
Yes. Still, I am just on
my level. So my brother is also facing problem of corona. That's why also I am depressed.
Even my family actually having COVID today.
Yes, sir. So that's why I am so disturbed that I am not able to take decision what to do. Not, but he is recovering.
Even actually, today itself, we got tested actually.
Yes, sir. And so, in your family, there is also COVID?
Yeah, everyone.
Everyone?
Even including me. Yeah. So, it's okay, but I can manage my classes, definitely. For you people, I can come online. No worries, okay?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that's the reason I'm just telling you. At least give examples, please.
Actually, this will distract our mind from current what I'm always going to thinking.
Yes, Chandrabhushan. That is absolutely correct. Okay. And that's the reason actually I'm taking classes online, because we have online classes from all the universities. So it's better.
All the universities are closed also.
Yeah, everything is closed in Indore.
Everything is closed, sir. In all the schools and colleges in Lucknow are closed.
Yes. That's the reason actually. But somehow, like, if you are indulged only, that's a behavior actually. Again, I'm telling you, it's all about the individual behavior. Like, person like me always want to get engaged so that protect myself.
If someone giving reply, then teacher also motivated for sitting.
Yes.
That's it. Definitely, we will reward you as and when possible.
Thank you, gentlemen. Okay. So students, any query please in these four types? And Miss Poonam,
no, sir.
In life actually, always distract yourself whenever you are in any trouble. Okay.
So yes, sir. It
will actually give you more constructive result life in life. Always remember. Okay. Yes. For example, if you have a fight with your husband, fight with your children, with your family members, even like very basic example I'm taking right now, just try to distract for some time, for a day, for hours. Automatically, you will have some constructive solutions.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so that's my request to you. If you
are. Thank you, sir, for advice.
Yes, definitely. Anytime. Okay. Hanji, so I think these three parts are clear: age,
yes,
life cycle stages, and personality. Clear? Okay, let's move to the next part now. That is about occupation, economic situation, lifestyle, and values. Okay. Now, how on the basis of occupation, definitely if you will just bifurcate the occupation on the basis of, you could say, either a business class or a job. Okay. because occupation may be categorized in further you could say classification we have. Okay, but usually when we classify, like, because there are freelancers, we talk about teacher, we talk about individual belongs to IT, belongs to engineering, with different occupations we have. Okay. According to occupation only, the person may have different, you could say, buying behavior. Okay, like for example, if I'm working in metros and working in an IT company for the shift of US and UK, I may have a different lifestyle because I have to start working in evening 7 to 8, and I'll work in the morning for 5 o'clock, because whole night, as per the Indian time I'm talking right now, you are start working with that. Okay. But when we talk about all such factors, that is one of the occupation I'm talking right now, person working as per the US-UK shift. Okay, one of the occupation type. Second, if you're talking about a particular person belongs to business class. A business class, definitely we have the persons having, you could say, having business of, you could say, emergency goods and services, having restaurant, having, you could say, manufacturing units, service sector, or anything it could be. So it depends on the personal, it depends on the occupation type and the sub-occupation classification. The person may have, you could say, different way of their purchasing behavior. Like a person belongs to, you could say, a business class, might have a different fashion requirements. A person belongs to a job, might have a different fashion requirements. Okay, so that's the reason eating habits also changes accordingly. Okay, so that's the reason how a particular occupation may also decide what type of, you could say, product which you will purchase, and your habits of purchasing will also differ. That is about the occupation. Yes, students, I hope so. It is clear.
Yes, sir. Yes. Thank you.
Next one we have economic situations. Economic situation, I think it's very simple, about the affordability of an individual. Okay. Affordability in terms of a lower class, or you could say BPL, below, yes, poverty line. Okay. Above poverty line, which includes your middle, lower class, lower middle, middle, upper middle, higher class. Okay. These are the basically the categories. According to you, you can see the example in front of me. Their dressing sense may differ, their brand preference may differ, their eating habits may differ, their way of life may differ. Their purchasing, like vehicle, if you talk about a particular person earning only 5 to 6 lakh in a month, in a year, having a different requirements of vehicles, but a particular person earning in lakhs or in crores actually in a month, in a year, having different requirements of vehicles, depends on their societal status as well. Okay. So that is again the one of the important point about economic situation of an individual, and accordingly the factors may also differ when it's come to purchasing behavior. Clear, I think so, students?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, sure. Next one, we talk about lifestyle. Lifestyle, like, what do you mean by lifestyle, first of all? Lifestyle, I think we may be categorized as per the locality if we talk about, okay? When we talk about lifestyle of the people of village, is very different. Urban areas, very different. Metro cities, very different. Suburb is very different, okay? So lifestyle is basically is all about the environment in which you are residing, or in which you are actually living your life. According to that, the societal factor may also enforce you to actually adopt the culture, adopt the values, because I'm just covering both the points, okay? Adopt the culture, adopt the values, adopt the, you could say, the consideration, the dynamics of the life, how we actually spend. Like, for example, if you're living in Mumbai, the lifestyle of Mumbai, nightlife of Mumbai, Bangalore, Delhi is very, very different. People start actually enjoying their life or enjoying their weekends after 11 or 12 o'clock. Okay. Because this is the requirement of that society. This is the actually need of that society. Okay. That is about the lifestyle and value. Value we can also consider in terms of your religion, your ethics, what I can say, your beliefs. Okay. So according to the values as well, like a particular person having the values to go to temple every morning. Okay. That is the value of a particular person, and how his lifestyle may get, you could say, influenced because of that values of the family. A particular person may be engaged in some social activities or some NGO activities, may have a different value system in the family. A person may have a, you could say, value system to eat together in the night, irrespective of whatever work you have, values. A values is basically nothing but the norms which the family or the society set. Like using your mobile phone while having lunch or dinner in the family is strictly not allowed. Values of the family. I hope so it's understood. Values and lifestyle.
Yes, sir.
Expecting an example now, please.
So the values that we get from the education for our career development.
Okay. According to lifestyle, definitely may differ.
So like moral values.
Definitely. Haan ji.
The peace and ethics.
Yeah, definitely. Even like one more important thing about the family structure and size. Okay. If you belong to nuclear family, your values and lifestyle would be very different. Like, for example, if I belong to Indore and living alone in Mumbai or metro cities, my lifestyle would be very different. But simultaneously, if my family is there with me, I have certain restrictions. I have certain, you could say, a consideration to keep in mind about this particular factors. Okay. So that is an important part about this particular values and the lifestyles. Depends on the family structure or family size as well. Clear, I think, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Thank you, thank you. So shall we move to the next slide, I think, if it is clear?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, sure. Next one, I think we have, that is about the psychological factors of buying behavior. Okay. Now, psychology, if we will discuss about, it's all about the internal instinct or internal voice of an individual, which may enforce, which may guide a particular person for its for his or her purchasing behavior. Okay. So when we discuss about this particular psychological factors, which are basically major, this five types, okay. Actually, it's included already there, but I think because of that diagram, it's not visible. Yeah, so now it's fine. Okay. So these factors include your motives, perceptions, learning, attitude, and personality. Okay. So student, I just for today and might be for tomorrow for a few days, I just need some frequent breaks actually, because it's difficult for me to speak up. Okay. So I'm just taking a break right now. Okay. And we'll discuss all these points one by one. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, sure. Sorry for inconvenience, but I think a smooth time. I need some actually energy in between. Okay. So need to have a break, I think.
No problem, sir. Please take it.
Yeah, thank you so much. So I'll get back to you at 6:50, okay? Sharp. Fine?
Okay, sir.
Okay, sir.
Yes, students. So shall we start, I think?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, sure. So, like, as we were discussing about the psychological factors about purchasing behavior, so the important points, which are these five major, you could say, forces which go for psychological factor, as we discussed already. Psychological factors are the factors which are associated with internal voice or inner voice of an individual, inner instinct of an individual, which influence him or her to purchase a particular product. Okay. Now we'll discuss all these five points one by one. Okay. Now the first point is motivation. Okay. Now what is motivation? First of all, it is basically a force or an ingredient in a particular person's internal system or mental system, which will actually guide him or her to purchase any product or services. Okay. Now, when we discuss about this motivation process, you can see that. For the definition is very simple. Driving forces within an individual produced by a state of tension caused by unfulfilled needs, wants, and desires. Okay. Now, tension doesn't mean that the negative aspect over here we're talking right now. Okay. Tension means a particular person is missing something in his or her life when it's come to his requirements. Okay. For example, if I want to purchase a pair of shoe for a function which is scheduled to be tomorrow. Okay. Until unless I won't be able to go to the mall and purchase that product, I will act the something which is going in your mind continuously since last night that I have to purchase something in the morning. Okay, for example, on exams. The exam is scheduled tomorrow. A particular person may have a positive tension that he or she has to perform in tomorrow's exams. Okay, so you can see that starting from the first one is unfulfilled need, wants, and desires. Okay, which will actually convert it into tension. Tension means the positive tension, and which will drive, means force them, motivate them. Okay. To appropriate behavior means how a particular person may able to actually achieve that product or services. Okay. And ultimately, if you have purchased that pair of shoe, if you have appeared for the examination, the mental relaxation is very, very different. Okay. So in that case, you can see that how this particular process starting from unfulfilled need, wants, and desire to felt tension to drive. To appropriate behavior and to goal or need fulfillment. Okay, and you can see that tension reduction. Tension means a particular mental relaxation we are talking about. Any examples, please? Really sorry. Yes, students, any example from your side?
So going to a salon, getting a spa, and it will also be. Motivation.
Okay.
Or having a favorite meal at your favorite restaurant is also desire. Or we feel sometimes when we are emotionally upset, a good food might get a good feeling for us.
Yes, yes, yes. Very good. What else, Rin? Anyone else? Any other example? I hope so. This point is clear. Any other example of this process? Hey, from your personal life example, if you can quote. Haji. It's very, very simple and common topic actually. Because if
like even doing the shopping also.
Okay. Any specific example? I'm just looking up.
For learning prospectus, like learning of English communication.
Yes, definitely. It's a positive motivation for someone because he or she wants to achieve that, you could say, fluency.
Same, sir, here.
Yes, yes. very good, Chandrabhushan. Thank you. Any other example, please? If not, we'll move to the next slide then.
Yes, maybe salary.
Salaries, okay. Can you please elaborate?
If a person is getting salary on proper time, especially for the factory employees.
Okay.
So they work really well instead of laziness and leaves.
Yes. Okay. Understood. Yeah, sure. So I think, so student, this part is clear. The motivation and the process.
Yes, sir.
Now, there are basically three basic motivation theories. I think if you have attended my classes of OB, you might have actually gone through with this theories of Maslow, Herzberg's, and Freud theories. Okay.
Actually, sir, I am not attending your OB theory because during that time I have a problem for logging issue.
Okay.
So I am not attended this classes, OB classes, total OB classes.
Okay. But I think, Chandrabhushan, you can access through IIBM YouTube because the lectures are already uploaded over there. So you may.
Okay. We'll check for that.
Yeah, sure. And in case any issues you have, any queries you have, please kindly approach me. Okay. We'll discuss that.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Okay. So we'll discuss these three parts now again, because if you have attended my classes, definitely it will be a very easy topic for you now. Motivations. Okay. I think most of the students I can see in the list right now, they were the part of those classes. Okay. Rakshash, Anuj, Poonam, Prakash, I think so. Rahul might be, Raksha as well. Yes. Okay. So these were the students, I think they were the part of that OB classes as well. Okay. So at that time,
this is Maslow's theory.
Yeah, Maslow's hierarchy theory. Okay.
Yeah.
So that I think we have covered up in those classes, how the motivation of a particular person's personal life. Okay. When we talk about, you could say the first factor, or you could say these are basically the hierarchy in which the particular person gets motivated in his or her life whenever he is actually passing a particular stage. Okay. The first need, you could say, when we talk about a particular person having some dependents in his or her family, the first part is called your physiological needs. Okay. Now, physiological needs is the basic needs, food, shelter, and clothing. Okay. Like we talk about breathing, food, water, sleep, sex, homeostatics, and exertions. Okay. So the basic, you could say, requirement of an individual. If this requirements is not being fulfilled, okay, because it's a human nature. Everyone having some mental needs, some physical needs in his or her life, at different stages of a particular person. Okay. And if that needs are not fulfilled, somehow the person may get distracted. He has some negative mindset. When we talk about living his or her life, he may feel frustrated even in his personal life as well as in the professional life. So the first and foremost thing is the basic need of individuals, which comes under physiological needs. I hope so it is clear, students. Because this is a basic need which you need to fulfill in someone's life.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Second, it's come about safety. Because once you have this basic needs, you have fulfilled on your dependency and your families. Definitely after that, the safety of yourself and your family is the utmost priority for each and every individual. Like we can just actually consider this example in our personal life as well. For example, like now it's a time for me having dependency, having dependent, like my mother, father, you could say my other family member, definitely they are dependent on me. Right now, I have definitely fulfilled the basic needs for them. Okay, they have actually good quality food, good, good water. Then we talk about good working, infrastructure of my house, everything I have. After that, when it's come to, I'm taking my example only. After that, you have a safety needs. Okay, safety in terms of Mediclaim policies. Okay, you could say life insurance policy of the family. Okay, when we talk about you're working in an organization, how protected you feel in the organization? Is there any insurance facility or is there any compensation in case of your death or accident? what would be the benefits given to the family or the dependents. That is covered under safety needs. Okay, for example, I have medical claim policy of mine, my family, my other family member. Definitely each and everyone is secured right now. In case if something happens to me or to any member, we have actually financially protected in these cases. Okay, so that is about the safety needs. I hope you know about endowment plans, term plans, okay, medical claim policies. Yes, students.
Yes, sir.
Perfect. Next one, I think we have about love and belongingness. Like once you cross the age of that teenagers, or like current scenario is very different. Okay. You have certain needs when it's come to friendship. Friendship definitely, right now, if you can see the scenario, it starts from a different age groups. Okay. If you are in the age of that teenagers, you have a different friendship goals. You have different friendship circles. You have different expectation out of them. Family, definitely you have that love and belongingness since your birth, and how connected you are when we come to the family belongingness or family attractiveness. Okay, when we discuss about the sexual intimacy, definitely it's very common, the physical need of an individual, because it is the utmost part, or you could say most crucial part, in order to get satisfied when it's come to physical aspect of an individual. Okay. So as you can see that the safety and physiological is more about psychological, means we are talking about the mental, but love belongingness is more about, you could say, physical. Okay. If you move to the next stage, once a particular person have everything, you could say, checked when it's come to their checklist, we will move to the next stage, which is called the esteem needs. Okay. These esteem needs are basically in order to achieve something. Like for example, if like being a faculty right now, I am doing my business. I am actually working as a freelancer for different universities in India. Okay, even in the US as well. So when we talk about my esteem, it's all about the achievements which I have actually conquered, which I have actually targeted in my life. Okay, for example, if I want to pursuing my PhD from IIM, if I want to get some certification from US universities or anything, it could be achievements and achievement, especially if you talk about it's, you could say again, vary from person to person, because definition of achievements are very different, because each and every individual having their own satisfaction level, on desire when it's come to respect from the family, respect from the society. Like being a faculty, I have a respect from everyone. Like even though like I'm teaching in the classes, there are so many students, those who are very elder to me as well. Okay. So in that cases, like even I'm teaching to executives, even I'm teaching to the correspondence students, even though if they are age of 50s or 40s, definitely they are elder to me. But because of the cadre, because of the position which we actually hold right now in society, we have that self-esteem. We have that achievements. We have that respect from all of my students. Okay. So that is again the one of the part of esteem needs. I hope so it is clear, students. Because a very simple example I'll give you, because one of my favorite student, actually he was around 70 plus. It's a very wonderful experience I have in my life about the respect I'm talking right now. He was retired SBI manager, I think so. Whether it is GM or something, I don't know. But he has very hunger. He's very hungry actually when it's come to education. He want to complete his more MBAs because he want to achieve some degrees. Okay. And he joined the part-time MBA in our institute. And I taught him for 3 years continuously. And the age of 70s, you can actually understand the level of respect which I receive from that individual is commendable, because it's like you have achieved something in your life, because the respect which you are getting being a faculty of those individuals, or even like the very basic example I've taken right now. But in my life, there are so many examples. The level of respect which you receive, it's somehow giving you more boost, more confidence to achieve something in your life. So that is again the one of the example of esteem needs when I'm talking about my personal life. Okay. When we discuss about this self-actualization. Now, like definitely, if I have achieved, I'm teaching since last, right now, if I talk about I'm teaching since last 10 years, okay. And when we talk about the achievements, definitely I talked about the different, you could say, certifications, different, you could say, achievements which I have received in my life. After that, the stage comes, which is called self-actualization. It is all about how you are serving to society. For example, if I am giving some, right now, definitely I didn't achieve that self-actualization, but still I'm trying my level best to give my 100% to society when it's come to some free education, support to some you could say underprivileged children. Okay, these what I actually talk, I'm talking about come to self-actualization. Okay, so in this case of self-actualization, the person may also want to achieve something when it's come to society, when it's come to some morality, when it's come to some activity which will give you some different level of, you could say, satisfaction in your life. This is called self-actualization. And 1 minute, please. So when it's come to this self-actualization, it is all about like how a particular person, apart from the show off to the society, or if some, definitely I do not want to prove anyone what exactly I'm doing when it's come to self-actualization. It is all about basically some deeds, some work, some devotion which you are giving in order to satisfy the needs of society. You want to just give your best in order to give them something which what you have learned in your life. Okay, so self-actualization usually comes after the age of 40s, 50s, when you want to actually achieve everything in your life. But after that, now you want to work for society. Okay, for environment, for being a volunteer of some society members or some, you could say, some social groups. So that is come under self-actualization. I hope so, it is clear.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Now, exactly expecting some examples from students now, please. Your own examples, please. I have given my example. You can just quote your examples now. I just want to have an introduction session as well from the student, because as of now, we didn't actually go for the introduction exactly. I don't know what exactly the person is, what exactly he or she does. So just want to know about the class audience, what exactly they, from where they belong, what exactly their work profile. I'll just take it after this discussion, please. Because it's something I'm just actually thinking since long that I want to have that discussion actually with the students to have a knowledge about the class. Yes, students. First of all, examples, please, of your own life. No need to hesitate. You can speak up in Hindi or English, doesn't matter. Please kindly speak up.
So, like in our daily life, we need this all. Food, water, all the metabolic process.
Yes.
That is psychological process.
Mm-hmm.
For after passing that stage, if we are qualified, we know we need employment.
Mm-hmm.
That how our resources for family we conducted.
Mm-hmm.
Because after some age, the person get, initially the person was between his mother and father, but after his or her marriage, there is another family that also needs.
Yes, very good, very good.
Purchasing phone is coming, sir. Accidental phone is policy. Coming.
Yes, Chandrabhushan, please continue.
For safety purpose, purchasing of accidental policy. Just I am fulfilling the my first stage.
Mm.
In last year, I purchased an accidental policy.
Mm.
This is also a safety for the purpose of safety of myself and for the family also. If I got an accident or I injured for that.
Mm.
And same thing happened in February month. I got injured and accidental policy will help too much for hospitalization. As well as you can say cash benefit also get during the period of I'm not going to job during that period.
Yes, yes, yes. Good, good, good. Then safety is done. Love belongingness, I think it's all about like person's marital status, okay? Or a societal group, if we talk about, okay? So it depends on individual whether he or she is married or not, or whether a particular person's social groups. According to that, your love and belongingness may differ. Okay, depends on your family size as well, whether you belong to nuclear family or a joint family. According to that, the love and belongingness may also differ. Okay, I think so, student. This is the part I think it's clear to everyone.
Yes, sir.
Okay, okay, perfect, perfect. Yeah. So move to the next slide now, please. That is called motivation research. Okay. Now, as I explained you about the motivation and the hierarchy of motivation, now when we discuss about the motivation research, it's all about how the companies can actually launch their products by taking some interviews, taking some, you could say, feedback, some reviews about any product or services. And according to that, the companies always always wants to satisfy that you could say missing motivation from their product and services. Okay, like as we already always see that whenever we are going to any shopping or any purchasing of any vehicles or anything in our personal life, we always expect from the company to introduce something new. Okay. Now, what is new is basically something creative, something unique, which we may expect from the companies. How the company can identify that the customer is brand loyal, the customer, why the customer is switching to the competitors, why the customer is basically, you could say, not trusting our brand, if we talk about. Okay, so for all such purpose, we always take a review from the customer. There are basic four methods we are discussing right now about motivation research. The first one is in-depth interview. Okay, now what happened, like usually recently I purchased one car, that is Maruti Baleno. Okay, after purchasing, definitely I got a call from the company head office and they asked certain questions regarding my satisfaction level. Okay, because definitely they always wants to know about the motivation or the satisfaction, whether it is being achieved after using that product or not. So the first part was in-depth interview. Okay, that is, but definitely they will actually ask many questions to you and they will actually quote you or definitely insist you to rate their services for various number of questions out of 10. I hope so. You might have an experience of this as well. Okay. So that is called in-depth interview, asking the questions from the customer. Clear, I think, everyone?
Yes.
Hanji. Association test. Okay. Association test basically is all about whenever like, if we are talking about any advertisements, if we are talking about any mall advertisements, any airport advertisements, railway advertisements, okay, hoardings on the flyovers, you always actually associate a particular brand with the help of word or picture, like Juju. Okay, you remember Juju for Vodafone. It's very common. Like when the Juju will came, you have a mindset that it is from Vodafone actually. What I can say, the brand symbol, if we talk about, okay. Like we talk about certain pictures as well, okay. Certain words as well, okay. Like an example. Any examples, please? Association test.
So Vodafone pub.
Uh-huh, yes. What else?
Yeah.
एक आइडिया बदल दिया दुनिया.
एक आइडिया बदल दिया.
एग्जांपल ऑफ
यस.
सुलभ शौचालय दे इंट्रोड्यूस दैट.
यस.
They introduce a picture around them, and the people used to see and they monitor what is this.
Like even like what I'm just that Philips, I think you might have that tagline they have, innovation and you. Okay, so that is about like for that Philips. Okay, always there is an advertisement they talk about innovation and you. That is for Philips. Okay. Definitely for each and a company, definitely they have some word associations, some pictures, actually some logos as well. With the help of that, we can actually recognize some slogans are there. Okay. Some it's a tunes are there, some musics are there. From that music itself, we can actually determine the which particular brand we are talking right now. Clear, I think. Anji. Any example, students, from your side regarding association test? Because association test is based on words only. Words, slogans, taglines. Projective technique is all about pictures and designs. Okay? Similar to association only. And focus group is basically nothing but we always target a particular group of customer in order to take the review and the feedback, because definitely it is not possible for the company to take a review from all. Like for example, Jio Fiber. Now, if I have to identify the you could say the effectiveness and the speed of Jio Fiber using different phases of time in a day or a night, definitely we cannot take feedback from all the people those who are using fiber. But you can actually target some focus groups, some cities, some area from where you can take the feedbacks. That is about the focus groups. Haan ji, students. Is this point clear, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Next one, we are moving now. That is about perception. I think I'll start from tomorrow. Okay, not in a condition to speak up much now. Okay, so I'm just thinking to take one case study if possible today. Okay, that we can discuss. Okay, I hope so, students. Is it okay, I think, with everyone? So I think I have to share one more, I think, book with you. That is of that is Kotler of Marketing Management. I hope so. Anyone having that ebook with you, Kotler?
No, sir.
No. Okay. So with whom I can? I think shall I share it with the emails?
Okay.
Sir, excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, have you discussed that questions?
No, ma'am. Actually, like I'm not well since last actually Friday or Saturday because of COVID actually.
Okay.
So yeah, that's a problem with me. Actually, I have written down in my list actually because I had to send IIBM test result mail. Okay, woman nahi kara hai, but because of the conditions is not favorable right now in my family. That's the reason.
Sir, take care for you.
Yeah.
Then other things are.
Yeah, even like it is in my list already actually, but I'm not able to do any work right now.
Okay, sir.
So okay, your antigen test came negative or positive?
Positive.
Oh,
okay.
Sir, nothing to worry now. So just take care of your health and family. Okay.
Yeah, definitely. Mm-hmm. Most clarity right now. Student,
I have a good experience in this not so called positive because it was very tough to face for only two to 3 days. After that, now so it will become normal.
Yeah. It is difficult actually because it's okay, but always try to make myself more strong, actually. That's the reason I didn't cancel the lecture today. Okay, students, no worries. Like what I'm expecting from you all, basically, I'm just sharing the books on WhatsApp, I think, because this file size is very large, actually. Okay, so that won't be possible to share it by emails. Okay, so as of now, I think I have the numbers of most of the students, I think. Okay, they have already texted me. So you can do one thing, student, just text me on my WhatsApp so that I will share it with you on WhatsApp.
Sir, you are not clearly audible.
Yes, pardon?
Sir, I can't hear you.
Okay, ma'am, just kindly check your connections. I think everyone can hear me properly. I hope so.
Yes, sir.
Okay, sir. You share that.
So, student, just do one thing. Just text me from your WhatsApp on my number. I will share it with you, the books of Philip Kotler. Okay, because it's a very fantastic book regarding all your topics being covered. Okay, so ebooks I already have with a few more ebooks I have actually, so that I can share it with you on WhatsApp. Okay.
Okay, sir. You can share it on the WhatsApp.
Yeah. Anuj, I think your number I already have. I just need one thing, I think, from your side, please. Can I have the small introduction of everyone?
Myself, sir, working with the paper industry. Total experience of 25 years working now.
So, Mr. Anuj, from where you belong? Yes.
Hello? Myself, I belong from the Meerut.
Meerut, okay. Fine. So you're working with which industry?
The Depriya product. Okay. Mamana Road Depriya product.
So is it belongs to?
Past experience of Bombay and Calcutta. And total 95 batch pass out from the IIT Roorkee, pulp and paper.
Okay. That's great.
Nowadays, I am actually working with the DGM for production. Oh. And always I am trying to helping the total, because if I am having the some opportunity, then I will give the person who is that technically qualified, then I will give the opportunity. So many persons.
Oh, that's great. I think nice to connect with all of you actually, because it's a really good pool of hub we have actually. We're pretty good pool, like different from belong to different feather actually we have.
As per your advice, education is not a limit.
Definitely.
Also with the age, any age you can get the education.
Mm-hmm. And that can change your mindset somehow actually in your life.
Ji.
Because what I personally believe, the subjects which we actually cover up, it's my personal experience. I'm very young to everyone, I think, in the class. Okay. But as per my personal experience, like teaching in various 16 to 17 universities I have taught in India, the experience which I always understand, whether it's marketing, whether it's finance, HR, the education always just transform your thinking process, nothing else.
Yes, sir.
If a person belongs to engineer, they're having different thinking process. IT belongs to different thinking process. Manufacturing belongs to different thinking process. And that thinking process we need to change, and that will transform society as well.
Idea is different, some technical and other, but the thinking sharing is same, sir. Share the thing, what you think, what you the knowledge, you share the knowledge also. Definitely. Any field.
Yeah, even like it's very common proverb we always use, sharing is caring actually. Even though if you belong to any level of your life, the potential or the credibility of a particular person reflects when he does not actually feel someone that he belongs to work at it.
But anyhow, same person is interesting for the getting the something. Yes. Without interest, nobody get anything.
Perfect, sir. Yes, absolutely fine. Thank you so much.
This is my experience, because I already tell my people and my colleagues, first you create the interest to learn. Then you get.
Definitely. I mean, like being a faculty, actually, I'm learning a lot from my students. Definitely, you people are definitely elder experience to me. But
you see, my whole family is the teaching side. My father, my brother, and all.
Okay.
I am only then the private industry.
Oh, that's great. That's great.
That paper industry.
Good, sir. Thank you so much, sir, for nice inputs, actually, and your experiences. I think Ayushi, what about you?
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, Anuj. Thank you so much.
Hello.
Yeah, Prakash.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, Ayushi. Yes.
Hi, sir. This is Prakash Patil. I'm from Karnataka. Actually, since from 6 years, I'm working in Saudi Arabia, working in L&T as a admin manager.
Okay.
And recently, I'm handling the accounts department. And so here, I'm working for the power plant of Naso and the project. It's the value of Naso, the project value is Naso, 1.5 billion.
Which city?
So, Dammam.
Pardon?
Dammam.
Dammam. In Karnataka?
Yes, Dammam. No, not in Karnataka, Saudi Arabia. Actually, I blank from Karnataka, Hubli. Karnataka, Hubli.
Yes.
Hubli. So, actually, I am working here in L&T in Saudi Arabia since from 6 years. In the last 10 years experience in India, the various states of Delhi, Goa,
okay.
Kerala.
So many states in Dubai, I think, in Saudi.
In Saudi Arabia, sir. Saudi.
Okay, that's great, sir. That's really great. Okay. Yeah.
So
right.
Actually,
yes, please.
I'm very much interested to learn something in all. This I really, really thankful for you at the institute at the DIM. And I'm really, really happy for that, and so your faculties and all. And so giving the so inspiration also for to get the higher education and have a good idea to take care of us. And thank you so much for so please take care of your health.
Yeah. Thank you so much, Prakash. Actually, it's badly needed right now. Okay. And thank you, I think, for your nice interaction, and Prakash. Okay.
Sir, first you take care of your health, sir. Then after that.
Sure, sir. Okay.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you so much. So I think, shall we sign out for the day, I think, students, if you will permit?
Yes, sir.
And please kindly text me on my WhatsApp, so I'll share it with you, that ebooks, okay?
Sure, sir. Thank you,
sir.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Sir, I don't have your contact number.
Ma'am, please kindly text me on 9926029096.
1 minute, sir.
Yeah, please.
9926029096. Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much. I think we'll interact more tomorrow with few more students. Okay. And we'll get to know about the exact scenario, what exactly I can learn from you as well. Okay. Thank you so much, Lisa.
Yeah, sure, sir.
Thank you so much. Please take care, everyone.
Thank you, sir. Take care. Thank you. You too, sir. Take care.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Sir, take care of yourself.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Drink water. Do salt.